Hello and welcome, this is Jeet Dulakia and you're watching It's Tomorrow News. Typhoon Mitag brings heavy rains and gusts to Japan, China and South Korea. A large and strong typhoon is bringing heavy rains and powerful winds to parts of southwestern Japan. The Japan Meteorological Agency says Typhoon Mitag was over waters about 290 km north of the Okinawan island of Yonaguni on Tuesday. It was moving north at a speed of 30 km per hour. The storm was packing winds of up to 144 km per hour with gusts of up to 198 km per hour. A maximum wind speed of over 155 km per hour was observed in the city of Ishigaki at around 7:30 p.m. local time on Monday. Strong winds were expected on Okinawa's Sakishima Island through the Tuesday morning. Caution is advised against high waves. Meteorological agency officials warned of violent winds, high waves and mudslides. The agency says a failure in the region's communication system has made it impossible to obtain weather data from the areas. The communication service provider entity West Japan's Okinawa Bureau says phone and other communication devices have been down throughout Ishigaki City and the town of Taketomi since Monday night. It plans to start restoration work as soon as the weather improves. The typhoon was expected to change course and head northeast on Wednesday. It could bring strong winds to North Kyushu and heavy rains to western Japan from Wednesday to Thursday. Weather officials are calling on people to remain alert at the last information. The Japan Meteorological Agency said caution is advised against high waves. The massive storm could bring strong winds to northern Kyushu and heavy rains to western Japan from Wednesday to Thursday. According to weather service AccuWeather, Mitag would have affected the Chinese city of Shanghai and far eastern areas of the China coast from Monday night into Tuesday night. Heavy rainfall will elevate the risk of flooding across Kyushu, Shikoku and western Honshu. South Korea will also be at risk for flash flooding and damaging winds with the greatest impact expected in southern and eastern parts of the country. That's all for now. For more news updates, stay tuned with us. It's Tomorrow News, Jeet Dulakia. For more weather updates like this, please subscribe to our channel.